Hello, welcome back to the next video on AWS series. This video is based on Amazon DynamoDB. In this video, we will discuss what is DynamoDB and we will cover the practical lab from the UI console, like how we can create the table and how we can insert the values in it. Amazon DynamoDB is a NoSQL database which is offered by the AWS, like other NoSQL database which is very famous, MongoDB. It's like that DynamoDB. It supports a document oriented data model. To create a table, we just define the primary key may be of type string, number or binary. Items can be added then into the table with a dynamic set of attributes. Item in DynamoDB correspond to a rows in SQL, and attributes in DynamoDB correspond to column in SQL. So we call attributes to the columns in DynamoDB, and we call items to the values or the cells, or we can say that simply rows, like we are saying in the SQL. DynamoDB support the following data type. For the scalar data type, we have number, string, binary and boolean. For the collection data type, we have the set, list and map. Its flexible data model and reliable performance make it great fit for mobile, web, gaming and tech, IoT, Internet of Things, etc. Now let's move to the console. Here we will create one DynamoDB table, then we will put the items in that. Let's name it as my first table. Primary key can be anything. Suppose I am taking ID here and of type number. Just click on the create. See, now we have the my first table here. Now click on items here, right? So far there is no item in it, so we can create the item from here to enter the values here. Create item, ID is 1, then we can add for second value is name and the value is XYZ, right? So we can add multiple column here according to our requirement. I'm adding one more. I'm just clicking on the save here. Now in this particular table, my first table, I have one row which has ID, mobile number and name. Now it's a document type, right? We studied here about it, that it's for document oriented data model. So what is document oriented data model? Now we will see it. Now suppose I want to add one more item there, and this time ID is 2. I have name ABC, and then I have mobile. Now I have one more value here that is of string type, and that is, suppose it's city, Pune, right? Let's add a few values here. State is Maharashtra, and save it. Now we can see here we have different column in the second row. Different means different attributes, and we have only 3 matching attributes in the first row. So document oriented means it does not create any issue if we have different attributes for each row set. We will create one more for more understanding. Now here instead of the name I will use first name. Let's say Raj and the last name anything XYG, right? Now instead of mobile number, here the value is phone number. Alright, let's save it. Now we can see here, each time whatever the attributes are there, we are inserting, it's not rejecting it, it's accepting and showing inside the DemoDB table. But in case of the RDS like SQL Server, we need to pass only that values for which column are defined first. But here first we are defining only ID, and after that we can set any attributes here according to our requirement, so it will work. Even it's a case sensitive. Suppose here, now instead of the name I will change the spelling here, right? It's name. You will see here this name and this name both are different one, because it's starting with capital, it's starting with small. So it is a NoSQL database, means it is a structure oriented, or you can say that it's a document oriented. Here the attributes name means column names for each item may be differ, so it will work accordingly. Now for the search, you can apply here, start search. If you have any query like see, I am searching for ID when number is 2, it's giving only that record. So in this way we can create the table. DemoDB, to create the table, just click on create table and then provide table name, ID name, and primary key can be of type only string, binary and number. Just click on create table, it will create table for us, and after that we can directly add the items from the items create item. We can create any item from the action, like we can manage it, like to delete any row or duplicate, edit, delete, right? So this is from the UI part, just for understanding like what is DemoDB. So DemoDB is a NoSQL database. And in the next way, one more important thing here, like whatever the action I am performing here, I am inserting here, deleting here, so AWS charges accordingly number of times we hit for the writing in a table or to read it. So it charges for read and write operations. And if we are using our DemoDB database in our application, in that case for the testing purpose, if we will hit the DemoDB at the AWS console, right, to make a connection with these tables, and we will for the testing purpose we will write and read from it, it will cost us, right? In that case it may be not cost effectively, because it will charge us even for testing purpose, for development purpose. So in that case AWS provide us one DemoDB local instance, which we can install on our local instance, and we can then use that one for our testing purpose and for development purpose. So in next video we will see how we can install the DemoDB local instance on our local system, and how we can use them with the .NET Core application to hit with it. So in next video we will just discuss, or we will install the local instance of DemoDB. So this is just a basic concept about the DemoDB. Lot of things are there, like capacity. So here we are providing read and write capacity units, so it's saying, we are saying 5. So based on the this it will charge us, right? If I am increasing, I am saying 500 read capacity unit, so accordingly it's charging us, right? So mostly we are in the production, we are keeping like this. And what the issue with which I already say, like if we use for the testing and development, so we will we need to pay extra there, right? So why that DynamoDB is provide AWS is providing as the local instance of DynamoDB. So in next video we will see that. So guys, we are just covering for the development purpose. Otherwise lot of things are there. We need to understand what is this backup, global tables. So lot of things like here we can create some global table and we can use same. It will be regardless the reason, right? So now for this one, this the table which I created here, this one exists in Mumbai region, right? Thank you everyone. In next video we will see in detail about the installing of the local instance of DynamoDB. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video with your friends. Provide your suggestions in the comment box. Thank you everyone.